men fired nearly a dozen shots at each other, despite being gravely wounded, and they were pronounced dead at the scene. The search for missing Dallas Hero continues. That story is next.
It is great.
This is Lifeline, Melvin Munn from Dallas, with Freedom Talk number 100. During the summer of 1969, there were massive pop festivals on the Isle of Wight in England, near Los Angeles, near Atlanta, Bethel, New York, and in Louisville, Texas. Hard rock fans and hippies in general poured into the grounds from just about everywhere. Law enforcement at all of these festivals was limited to maintaining order, keeping traffic moving, and assisting the injured, wounded, and drug-stricken with a special hospital tent set up for that purpose. Hallucinatory drugs were sold, used, given, and traded in full view of officers and private citizens alike. I know best the Texas International Pop Festival that was held in Louisville, Denton County, Texas, because it was close to Dallas. This is Freedom Talk number 100, and you may order printed copies at the rate of 3 for 25 cents from Lifeline. I'll be back after this message from our Lifeline sponsor.
Commune, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Do you, when did you leave home?
Oh, quite a long time ago.
Have you been back?
Oh, sure, yeah. I have a very good relationship with my family.
What is the philosophy, more or less? It's a hard thing to ask, but what is the philosophy behind this? What are you trying to do?
Have some fun. Enjoy ourselves. Just try to stay out of the way of hassles and go through life being happy. You know, you can do it either way, happy or sad, and it's just more fun to do it happy.
From everywhere, people are coming, they're walking and riding. like Woodstock has done. Cause it is the first time they've been free.
You're gonna have to scream for it.
Now, what is a pop festival? It is a commercial promotion of private interest for financial profit. Usually, promoters borrow, lease, or rent a public or private site. They contract for major rock and roll bands who appear on a temporary stage with psychedelic lights and massive electronic sound equipment. The audience sits, or lies, or lolls, or rolls, or wrestles on the ground, the grass, the gravel, or whatever. It's all out of doors. Neither rain, nor hail, nor public opinion deters the savage attack on human eardrums, public laws, private morality, or just plain decency. The audience comes from all over. They arrive in leased buses, campers, cars, and trucks. Or they may hitchhike, ride motorcycles, motorbikes, and even now and then a bicycle. But they get there.
Mayor, this is the first thing of its kind in this area. What do you think about it?
Well, I have to reflect on it. I think that it's the largest thing that's ever been in this area, of course, and it's the greatest as far as the number of people concerned of anything that I've seen since possibly a real large football game. But as far as the total number of people, I think that exceeds anything that I've ever seen.
It's strange. There are a few groups with us. There are a few groups in the industry who perform with great spirit only when they are performing for free. Could we welcome warmly, please, our friends, the Grand Funk Railway.
Well, then let me down south too much. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about it so that you understand what I'm talking about. Now, down there, we got a plant that grows out in the woods and the fields. Looks something like a turnip green. Except it ain't. Cause everybody called it poke salad. Now, used to know a girl lived down there. And she'd go out in the evenings and pick her a mess of it. Carry home and smoke it. Carry home and cook it for supper. But that's about all they had to eat, side cornbread. But they did all right. Down in Louisiana, where the alligators grow so mean. But lived a girl that I swear to the world, made the alligators look tame. Poke salad, Annie. Oh, poke salad, Annie. Everybody said it was a shame, cause her mama was working on a chain gang. A mean, vicious woman. Go down by the truck patch and pick her mess of poke salad. Carry it home in a toast sack. Poke salad, Annie. Oh, the gator's got your granny. Chomp, 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 chomp. Everybody said it was a shame, cause her mama was a wicked on a chain.
There was little or no physical violence at any pop festival last summer. In addition, observers, including our own, saw the clean, well-behaved, and normal young Americans who came by the thousands just to hear the music. But we also saw other thousands whose appearance would frighten many of us squares were we to meet them individually on a dark street at night. Dirty, matted, and fierce-looking hair, beards, and mustaches characterized many of the young men. Among the hippies who do not wear beards or mustaches, deliberate, and hypocritical cover for its underlying aims. This is Freedom Talk number 100, and you may order printed copies at the rate of free for 25 cents. From Lifeline, Dallas, Texas, 75206. Share your surplus copies of Freedom Talks with judges, educators, and people you meet on the bus. I'll be back with more on hippie hypocrisy after this message from one of our Lifeline advertisers. Labor Day weekend bash called the Texas International Pop Festival at Louisville, Texas, nudity became a major extension of the hippie social revolution. A few had shed all their clothes at Woodstock and wandered among the thousands without interference from anybody. In Texas, they pushed their luck even further, and they got away with it. The festival music grounds were an enclosure into which only those who could afford a ticket were allowed to enter, some distance from the festival site or the shores of a large lake. The first nudity came when several early comers, male and female, removed all their clothing on a public beach and played in that public lake. Now, the hippie cult hasn't changed all that much. In general, the true hippie courts dirt, filth, and disheveled appearances. It shocks the squares. Bathing is certainly not one of their big things. It's obvious many of them rarely go near a bathtub or a shower. So why this dedication to hygiene and cleanliness all of a sudden? Well, the answer is simple. They didn't want to bathe. They just wanted to show the straight people they could get away with it. And they did.
I've been chief police of Louisville for just about a year.
God bless the chief!
I can't say too much for you folks out here, as orderly as you've been. You show the elders something that they've needed to be shown a long, long time. Yeah. We have had about, I'd say maybe 1,500, 2,000 campers on the lake. Out of this, we have had no arrest. Hey! The only arrest that has been made, the best I can judge, would be from people coming in. The people who gave me the most trouble, not you folks, but our good old hometown gawkers.
Shortly, we'll continue.
Or share bags. Use the buddy system with your pants. When you come out, take your pants off and give them to your naked comrade who will go in. And we can all get, in fact, we might even walk out of the water if you please.
Well, put on some overwear or just slam a little mud on your yash. Whatever it takes to cool these old ladies out is groovy. But all these people that are going to see naked people, obviously nobody's naked. However, if you'd like to get a good look at the people with some clothes on, they're all standing around.
What I'm seeing is that the old Baptist ladies cannot handle the fact that in their locus there are naked people.
They don't mind anything else that's going on. Just wear some pants while you're doing it. Until sunset tonight. Otherwise, they're going to, you know, try and set up some kind of scene.
mayor, who has asked the police chief, and we had this insane meeting at 5 o'clock in the morning, that what we try and do is to tell everybody, you know, like if you want to turn it on, it's cool, but be sure you're wearing some pants. So if everybody put on some underwear or something when you went in, it would take the heat off the police, who have been groovy, and the mayor, who has been groovy, and us guys. Okay, there he goes, he's going under. And meanwhile, we got the old ladies out looking for bathing suits for everybody. If anybody doesn't have any, they're out looking for them. And the thing is, dig it, that you can see that I'm not shitting you or anything. I mean, they want to call in the militia or something. And I say the world is watching us and we are our own police. And I'm asking you all to help. And if you see somebody else, just tell them the truth, because the truth works.
What happened out here yesterday, Paul? You could tell us about it.
Well, I wasn't out here yesterday for any trouble, but I can tell you what I saw this morning,
all right,
what the nature of it was. Early in the morning when the sun was just first coming out, you know, people on the beach just started waking up, you know, cleaning up in the water and shit, swimming. And all night, you know, these rednecks been out here,
yeah,
cleaning, you know. They'd been out here, their little boats purring out there all night long, you know, getting drunk and laughing their asses off at the hippies, you know. And so, you know, you started to swim out to it. They'd be so afraid of you, you know, they'd just swim off, you know. Their suppressed minds, you know, just couldn't take what was going on, you know. And they just said, well, this is just so much shit, you know. They're probably over there sleeping with niggers, too, and really putting them all down, you understand?
On stage, and I think in the applause department, you beat out the CTA and Led Zeppelin, and you just tied Janis Joplin. How do you feel about that?
I feel pretty good, know that I'm in such good company.
How do you feel about the kids now?
Tremendous. They're a tremendous bunch of kids, and as I said, we can all learn something from them.
After Chief Adams spoke to y'all, about all I can say is anticlimactic. I would like to say this, that give you my personal appreciation for the manner in which everybody has behaved. As far as crowds go, there's never been such a great crowd insofar as the way and manner that you've acted. And I want to compliment you for this. How many have ever seen a Texas OU game? Well, I don't want to show any preference on my part, but I'm from Texas. But what I want to make a comparison, after seeing several Texas OU games, people don't behave themselves like you have here.
We'll be right back.
way down inside. Woman, you need
why? Oh, no, oh,
turn to the door.
Dazed and confused. Thank you.
for you. Lots of people talking, few of them know. The soul of a woman was created below.
Yeah.
But one of these days you're going to have to leave and raise children. How do you answer them?
Oh, yeah, they do. But one of the best things is we usually have our children with us. There's about 10, 12 that we have. Some of them are little babies, and some of them go to about 7 years old. And they're magnificent. And I'm going to stay around and have my children in the commune. It's a lot better. Each child has about 30 adults, some of them and most of them proficient in just about every area you can think of. It's one of the finest teachings and learning things for children to grow up in. It makes a lot of healthy kids.
You feel that the commune idea then will last?
I don't know. You know, there are a lot of books out on communes that have flopped through history for different reasons. But I think nowadays the commune has got a lot to do with the population explosion, how do we learn to live together in a very close setting. And it's also got to do with a lot of people who are very tired with the money ideas. In the commune, you generally, at least in our commune, you pool the money. We have a money commissioner who we trust to dole it out and take it in. And he's got control of all the finances around, and it's a pretty good way of life. I like it a lot.
You're going to stick with it?
Oh, I think so. I try to leave every so often, and can't do it for long. I'm always right back.
Everybody line.
Dr. R.E. Branch.
And where are you from?
I'm from Jackson, Mississippi originally, but I'm a resident of the VA hospital here in Dallas.
I see.
But
what, you are staffing the medical tent out here?
Right, we've worked in all the first aid stations. There are three first aid stations out here altogether.
How big a medical crew do you have out here?
We have, there are 10 residents staffing the three first aid stations, and that's a pretty good bit of ancillary personnel. There are a number of nurses and other medical aides that we've been helped with.
What have you run into, or what have you found that you didn't expect or did expect, or just give us a general idea of what's going on?
Mainly, we really hadn't run into anything we didn't expect. The quantities of what we've seen has kind of thrown me sometimes. Mainly what we've seen is people with superficial lacerations that have cut their feet, not wearing shoes, and asthmatics. A lot of people with heat exhaustion that, you know, just come in, drink some water and some salt tablets, and they'll be okay.
How about any big drug problems out here, or just the normal amount? There's not an overly amount of it.
Not really. There haven't been. I haven't seen really nearly as many as I had expected out here. We have seen some. I think, all in all, it's pretty much the gamut of, as far as a drug problem today, just about anything that you can imagine is here. It's not in nearly the quantity that I expected it, but we really hadn't seen too many problems. There's some kids with bad trips, but they're no big problem. There hasn't been much of a problem at all.
Have you worked anything like this before, or is this your first time?
This is my first time. It's really an experience.
How do you like it?
I don't think I'd like to make a steady diet of it, but it's really been an experience. I really enjoyed working out here.
How do you like the kids and everything?
I like them. They're all, the thing is, the people that come here, they're really sincere. They have a good time. They really are well-mannered and well-behaved. I can't say that I agree with everything that they do, but there are a number of spectators. I call them spectators that come in, curiosity seekers, that cause most of the trouble that's had out here.
Gonna have to scream for it.
The Louisville Pop Festival made many things crystal clear. That is, that the most zealous of these young people are dead serious about turning on an entire youth generation. They have almost a missionary zeal about converting the straight and square youngster to smoking, sniffing, and popping illegal drugs, shucking off their clothes, blowing their minds, digging each other, and totally wrecking the traditional moral standards of this country. In no other light can any objective person understand thousands of young Americans enduring the rain, wind, and mud of Woodstock, the heat of Louisville, or the short rations, blistered feet, paralyzed traffic, and partial public condemnation at all festivals.
That older people fear you because you have long hair and you live in a lifestyle that's alien to them?
I suppose there's a certain amount of fear, but again, all fear is only based on misunderstanding. You're only afraid of something as long as you don't understand it. And as soon as you come to closer terms with it, it's not as frightening anymore. So at first exposure, a lot of times, there's some fear involved. But if a little patience and compassion on both parts is shown, we get it together and there's understanding.
Have you thought about what you will do as you grow older? Do you intend to live like this always?
I don't intend to grow older.
What it stands out in your mind over these 3 days in the way of the crowd and everything?
The enormity of the whole festival is something that's probably a once in a lifetime thing that you'll always look back on and say, gee, I was there.
One question that's on everybody's mind, well, most people's mind anyway, the drug problem out here. Have you had any hassles with that?
No more than what you'd expect for a big crowd like this. We've made about 14 arrests. These arrests have been made away from the area. I've only know of two that's been made actually in the area itself, and there was no hassle, no trouble at all. Once again, your friends came into play.
Mm-hmm.
We work very closely with their security, and they work with ours, and we have no problem. Roy, I wouldn't do a thing different. I'd do it exactly as I did, and no changes.
Now, there are an awful lot of newspapers and radio and television stations and people saying that you should have gone right in and made a bunch of narcotics arrests right off.
I've read it too, but all I can say is I think if they'd take another look at it, analyze the situation out, I believe they'd act just the way I did, to try to avoid a riot, because that's what it would have turned into more than likely we'd made the arrest.
Do you see any conflict in your being security chief and police chief?
No, Roy, I believe if anybody would have bothered to come around and ask me before they started all the furor, well, how come you were down there and how come you were getting the money? I believe if you would have checked with me, you would have found out I was on vacation, and whatever I do on vacation is my own business.
Mind telling me how much money you got?
I made $300, $100 a day down there from the festival. Yeah. I've heard 25 cents a head, which makes $25,000, but that's a little bit erroneous.
In your leaving, if you'd be kind enough as to remember that we sort of borrowed this place for a certain period of time, you all paid for it one way or another. In our gratefulness, we wish you to extend to the people of the community the respect that perhaps you would have wished to have had come from them. And please accept a thank you from us for making it so pleasant. Hoping that each one of you will receive exactly what you wish the next man. Until we get together again, wishing you a very good life.
A girl named Star from the hog farm asked if I'd make a little rap and pass out some blue plastic bags. So anyone that would like to clean up a little 10-foot area around them can come up to the stage and get some bags. And
the mayor of Louisville publicly stated in a post-festival news conference that he was warned, he did not say by whom, that unless the police left the festival crowd strictly alone, there would be a hippie-led attack upon the town of Louisville, and that they would burn and tear the entire town to the ground. He specifically said there were threats of murder, of rape, and other crimes if police dared to arrest young people for nudity, indecent exposure, drug use, or any other violation of law. Once more, there is the hippie hypocrisy.